Avem onoarea să avem în studioul televiziunii noastre pe Dr. Ravi Zacharia. Thank you so much for taking the time and coming to our studio here at McCormick Place at the Romanian Pentecostal Churches Convention in Chicago. And our audience, they know you and they have questions for you. And one of the questions that I already sent to our studio is the following. Would you like to share with our viewers what Ravi Zacharia International Ministry is trying to achieve in general and specifically in Romania?
Thank you, Marian, for asking that question. Our man in Romania is Vlad Krznic. He's been with us for several years, even at the same time now as he's pursuing his doctoral program in the United Kingdom. Our global mission is really to respond to the hard skeptics, to hostile audiences, to honest seekers, those who raise serious questions about the gospel of Jesus Christ. We assume they are very sincere in what they ask, and now our ministry has 47 full-time apologists placed in 15 countries globally. That is the remarkable growth of this ministry over the last 30 to 31 years. And what we want to do in Romania is the same thing that we want to do around the globe. That is, we respond to four audiences: the academic, the business, the arts, and those who are in political leadership. So whether it's the academic world, the business world, the arts world, or political leadership, these are the four institutions that shape the culture and ethos of a country. Now, obviously, we're in churches and other arenas, but we try to get into these molders of a culture, molders of the soul of a people. And the goal in Romania will be the same. Romania has had an incredibly gripping history when you think of what has just happened in the last 27 years, and people who've been wounded best understand the hurts of other people, and the wounds of Christ speak very loudly to a wounded society. That's the first thing. The second thing is we have a generation of young people who have sort of academically been trained to think without God. And as a result, their lives have become empty, their souls are left unfed, and the major questions of life, of origin, meaning, morality, and destiny, are left really incoherently answered. So through our leadership in GLAAD and several others, our apologists hope to get there time and again, respond to these audiences, and hopefully make a difference in this magnificent country, which could be a very pivotal part of the future for Europe too and the world.
Thank you so much. In May 2015, you were a guest at Cluj, at the event that was called Belief, and so many young people overwhelmingly came and filled that almost 10,000 seats auditorium. You have a lot of fans in Romania, and they are in the young side. And I have a question for you from the young people. They would like to know the following. Our youth find themselves between the modern Western culture and the conservative Christian Romanian culture. Do you have any advice regarding how they can stay true to themselves and God in the midst of these sometimes opposing influences?
Yes, actually, I'm a fan of Romania myself. I've been there for several years. I started coming in the late 80s into Romania. I was in Pitești at that time, and since then I've been in Senaia and then in Cluj and in of course, in Bucharest and a few other cities during this time. But what you're raising is so true of the entire mix of those who have come from another country. When I think even of my Indian culture and how many hundreds of thousands, if not millions, are now in North America, it is not so much that they have come from Romania, which sort of, as you've described it, is conservative Christian background, to a liberalized so-called progressive culture in America. It is the fact that America itself has changed. An average American raised in a Christian home is sort of caught in no man's land. They are standing on quicksand where moral absolutes are are no longer believed in and subscribe to, relativism holds sway. How do you navigate? How do you find your balance for your own values, for your family's values, for the gospel of Christ? And what I would say to them is, always be wise and careful in how you listen. Don't expect to beat up on the opponent. Try to win the opponent. And the way you win the opponent is with your attitude and your personality. All questions they ask, you must assume that they've been very genuine, that they've been sincere. Some may not be, but give them the benefit of the doubt. They are looking for two things in life. They are looking for meaning individually, and they are looking for coherence. And if you don't have meaning and coherence, life becomes bankrupt. You go to the hedonistic, pleasure-oriented, and what happens, you empty yourself in the process and come back even having less meaning than before. So build relationships, build friendships, go generally in a gradual manner, not in a dramatic manner. Listen to their questions, defuse the hostility, and always deal with it in a kind way. Read well, understand well. Really, the sciences, philosophy, arts, all of these have a place. Now listen to me very carefully. When you're communicating to a person, you actually communicate at three levels. You communicate from logic, you communicate from the arts and illustration, you communicate around the kitchen table and application. Go in that sequence. Argue wisely, illustrate carefully and brilliantly from the arts, apply it around the kitchen table. So we must raise our children to understand thoughtfully and critically evaluate questions. If you read well, if you understand how to deal with the argument, the illustration, the application,
bine,
you can really
ceea ce
do
citim
very well. Ask every questioner questions that will open them up within their own assumptions. Jesus did this. When a man said to him, good master, what should I do to attain eternal life? You know, you and I would have immediately given thoughts on how to find salvation. Instead, what did Jesus say? Why do you call me good? There's none good but God. What Jesus is saying is, are you really calling me God? And if you're calling me God, will you listen to me? Or are you saying you can be good apart from God? You see, what's happening is he's opening the person up within their assumptions. Be careful of being immersed in a counterculture. Don't buy in to what you're swept away by it. Hold on to the values that Christ has given to you and know how to communicate those same values. Your life will be a light in a dark world, and people will see that you have coherence, which is exactly what they're looking for.
Thank you so much, Dr. Zechariah. We really appreciate that you took the time to come and to speak with the Credo's audience on our 10th anniversary. We're looking forward for a long-term relationship with your ministry and with yourself, and hopefully you will have more time to visit us at our worldwide events and to address our audience. It would be our pleasure as well if we could partner up and put your programming on Credo TV.
Well, it was an honor to be included, to see 10,000 there, to see hundreds coming to in response, and I'm looking forward to coming back. They met the mayor in Cluj, and we hope someday to do a prayer breakfast with the mayor and hopefully nationally too. God bless you all from the Romanian church, and I hope we'll be able to bless you again. Thank you for having me.